Hello friends, welcome again. And this is my new project IoT GPS cloud based courier tracking system. And I have developed this project in PHP and MySQL. And the version for the PHP I'm using is the PHP version 7 and the MySQL version is 5.6. And this is a cloud based, and even if you have the local WAMP server or JAMP server, then you can configure this project on the WAMP and JAMP also. Also, if you are using the LAMP, means Linux operating system, then you can configure and run this project on the Linux operating system also. Also, if you are using the Mac, then you can install the XAMPP or the MAMP softwares on your Mac operating system and configure this project. This is a cloud-based because of if you are using any type of cloud system like AWS, Azure, or GCP, Google Cloud Platform, then you can configure and run this project on those cloud system also. In the AWS system, you can launch this application on the EC2 instances. You can easily configure this project on the EC2 instances. And we have developed the API from which you can configure that API on the mobile devices or any of the GPS tracking devices to send data from those devices to the application. And this application will track the GPS, means the real-time location of the couriers, and it will plot the things on the map, right? This is the main feature of the project, means this application will track the real-time location of the courier, and you will be able to see the tracking details real-time on this web application, right? So this is the main objective of this project, right? So for devices, you can develop the device using the Arduino or the Node MCU, and you can add the GPS module over the Arduino or the Node MCU module. Or if you are using the mobile application, then you can launch the mobile application over there, and through that mobile you can send data, means the current lat long of that mobile application to that application, and this application will take care about all of the things, means the plotting of the graphs, inserting and managing the lat long of the real-time courier devices, right? So this is the main features of the project. So let's start what we have developed inside this project, right? So this is the home page of the project. So there are four terms. This is the IoT based application, Internet of Things based application, and for devices, for hardwares, you can use the mobile devices, you can develop your own Arduino or the Node MCU devices, or you can use any type of GPS devices which provides the facility to call the API and sending to lat current and lat and long to the application. We have exposed the API from which you can integrate this application with any of the devices, right? So this is the standard application from which you can send the lat long, and this application will perform according to that lat long, right? So let's start. So this is the home page of the application. So this is the so one more thing. So for front end development, I am using the HTML, CSS, JavaScript, some of the jQuery library also I have used, like for plotting the graphs and creating form validations, I have used the jQuery applications. Also, this is a bootstrap theme, means if you open this application anywhere, means in any of the device like mobile devices or the big screen or the tabs, then the UI will not be distorted. Means UI will work perfectly on all of the devices. That's why it's a bootstrap theme, right? So let's start. So this all of the technology I have used for developing this project, right? So this is the home page of the project. You can see this is the information. If you want to change the image, if you want to change the content, then you can do it from here, right? This is the about. This is some of the about of the project, and it's a static page. This is a modules page, what we have developed. So I have added only three modules here, but there are many of the modules available inside the project. I have not mentioned it here, right? This is a tracking information from where you can track your shipments, track your couriers. For that, you need to know the tracking ID of your courier, right? Once you enter the tracking ID, it will show you the tracking information over the graph as well as the listing, right? with the date information, like I am showing you. So the tracking ID is 10,001. Then once you click on the track shipment, then you can see this is the courier details and this is a customer details, right? And this is a customer map, courier map tracking, right? So you can see these are the places from where the courier is moving, right? If you click on the place, then you will be able to see the date and the place, right? And after that, you will be able to see all of the informations about the places, right? And if you want to see the informations, then this is the first, means it's sorted according to the places. The first means the courier starts from the place one, serial number one, and it's with the serial number five. So this is all about the information, and these locations are coming from the devices which you have integrated from this application. It might be your mobile application or the Arduino or the NodeMCU application or any of the GPS devices which you have integrated with this application, right? So these informations are coming from those devices. There is no form for adding the lat long here, right? I will show you the API later. So this is the track shipment information. This is the admin login from where you will be able to log in. See, this is a contact us. Okay, this is a static contact us page. I am not saving the value of this contact us page anywhere into the database. Even I am not sending any type of email and SMS from this page, right? So this is the front end application. So the main part of this application is also, there are two type of UI in this application. The first one is the front end UI and second one is the back end UI. Means there is a UI for the customer and there is a UI for the admin. Means there are two types of themes has been integrated in this application, and this makes this system more attractive also, right? So this is the front end UI which you are seeing. Now I am jumping onto the admin login, right? So you can see this is a separate UI. You can see the UI has been changed, right? So the user ID is at admin and the password is test. So once you log inside the system, you will get the different, totally different UI here, right? From where you will be able to manage the things, right? Manage the couriers, customers, tracking details, each and everything you will be able to manage from here, right? So let me go through one by one. So let me go through the UI first. So you can see this is a bootstrap theme also. And if you can see this is like that, you can, if you want to hide the menu, then you can hide from here. Like, so the first thing is the dashboard. So this is a dashboard from where you will be able to manage the things, right? These four options is available in this menu. Right. So let me go through one by one. So once you click on the customer, add customer, from here you will be able to add the customer details, the full name, mobile, email, date of birth, address, line one, city, state, country, right? Before starting the courier details, you need the details of this customer first, and you can fill the customer details in this form first, right? And it will be saved into the database. So this is the management type of thing, right? There is no need of any devices to manage the things here, right? So this is a totally CRUD application, create, read, update, delete on information of the customers, right? Which is needed for tracking the courier details, right? So next one is a customer. Second one is a customer report. So this is the customer report. So I have added only two customers, but you can add any number of customers, 1,000 of 10,000 of customers you can add here. But what happened if you add the 10,000 customer? Don't worry, this is a very smart table and the pagination is already integrated in that. Means you can set the pagination preferences like this. This is the pagination preferences. You can set the number of records from here. Means if there is the 10,000 records, so you can set the pagination preferences. Mean how many records you want to see in the first page and how many records you want to see on the second page. So this is the very smart table. Even you can sort the record from here. You can see if you are clicking on the name, then the information is sorting, right? So you can see this is the pagination. Currently there are two records, that's why pagination is not coming. But if there are more than 20 records, 10 records, then once you set the 10 records, then pagination will come automatically, and you can, these things will be enabled automatically, and you can jump on the page on clicking on the previous and next. And if you can jump on, you can jump on the page on clicking on that page number also, right? It will show you the how many records are here available, right? So currently there are two records, but if you are 10 10,000 records, then you will be able to see all of the 10,000 records here, and it will show you this number of records are available here inside the application. This is the search from where you will be able to search the things. This is a real-time search, right? Real-time search means if you enter any of the terms here, then it will search automatically, right? Like I am entering the Kaushal, then you can see the Kaushal is searching real-time. There is no database hits I am making here. It's searching on the real-time. But if you are removing the things, then you can see Rahul. I think Rahul term is available in both of the. So if you want to search from this mobile number, then just click on this and you will be able to get all of the records which belongs to that mobile number, right? So currently there are only one record associated with that mobile number. That's why it's one record is coming, right? Even you can edit the records from here. So you can, once you click on that, then you will be able to see the all of the customer details. You can edit it and update it into the system, right? Okay, so you can see there is data updated successfully. Right, so this is the customer information. So this is a very smart table, and this smart table we have integrated with all of the reports, right? So this is the device report. So this is the add customer and the customer reports, right? This is the device report from where you will be able to add the devices. I think this must not be available here. So I need to remove this first, right? So there is in your, if you get that this application, this select courier will not be there. Okay, by mistakely I have added here, right? So from here you will get the two things, device name and descriptions. In the device name, you need to add the device name and the descriptions, right? So once you add this device name and the description, that you will get the device ID, and you need to add the device ID in your device, right, to send the data. And that device ID belongs to the couriers, right? So the main advantage of the main feature of this application is you can track multiple couriers with a single device. Suppose if there is a courier boy and if he is handling 100 of couriers, then a single device will be able to capture the information of those 100 couriers, right? And according to that device location, the courier details will be displayed, right? The courier location will be displayed. Suppose there are 100 couriers, but 10 couriers has been delivered, then you will be able to see only those 10 locations, right? Which that courier has taken by that courier boy, right? At the 10 times means you will be able to. So there is a device one, and if the courier boy is taking the device, moving the device from location 1 to location 100, right? So there are 100 location, but the courier 5 means if there is a courier 5 which has moved from the location 10 to location 15, then that courier will display only the information from location 10 to location 15, not that 100 location. This smart functionality has already been implemented in the system, right? So there, this is the advantage, means from a single device you will be able to track multiple of the courier details, and it will show you the proper tracking information, right? And if you change the device from location 1 to location 10, then it will be from location 1 to location 10, then that courier will be associated with multiple device. Okay, can be, suppose if there is a device which belongs to Noida location, right, and if it's traveling from Noida to Mumbai, then what will happen, it will start from Noida, from device 1, from Noida device, and if it belongs to if it's moved to Delhi location, then in the Delhi region it will belong to Delhi device, and after that if it moves to the Jaipur, then it belongs to the Jaipur device. Then what you need to do, that at the every moment of that courier you need to change the device, right? And you will be able to track all of the information of that device, right? So all of the device information will be tracked by this application, and you will be able to see proper graph, Google map on the application, right? So this functionality has been implemented on the system. right? So this is the device report. So currently I have added this number of devices, 5 devices, right? So you can see there is the devices, Noida location, Delhi location, Jaipur location, and the Ahmedabad location and Mumbai locations. This 5 devices, right? So suppose if there is a courier tracking 1001, it starts from the device ID 1001, right? Device name 1001. Then if it belongs to 1, 3, and 5, then at the time of tracking it will show all of the informations, right? So what you need to do, that you need to change the device name into the courier details, right, at the every tracking, and you will be able to find out the proper tracking, real-time tracking details over the device. So this is the feature, right? This is the courier details, and once you so this is the device report, right? And it is also a smart table from where you will be able to filter out the details. This is a courier from where you will be able to add the courier. So this is the couriers from where you need to add the device. So this drop down will contain all of the devices which is available in your system, right? So you can see this all devices is available here. You need to select that devices, and after that that courier will associate with that devices, and at the every moment that device will send the lat long miss, the location of their location, and it will send the lat long, and that lat long will be information, that lat long will be stored inside the database, and you will be able to see the proper information of the trackings, right? This is a select customer, and you will be able to fill all of these details here, right? This is a customer courier from where you will be able to see the information of the courier. So these are the information, and after that there is a status from where you will be able to see that what is the status of the delivery, right? So these are the delivered stage, so you can't click on here, but if you click on the mark delivered here, then the tracking of that courier will be stopped. Means if there is the 100 couriers belongs to device one, and if 10 courier details if you marked as delivered, then no tracking information will be saved inside the database for that 10 devices which has been marked to delivered, right? So this is the feature, and it will show the all of the location from location X to location Y, okay, till it has not been marked to delivered, right? So once you mark that to delivered, then you will be able to see the information about the from location X to location Y till the time it has not been marked to delivered, right? So this is the edit information from where you will be able to update the device information, sorry, the courier information, right? This is a location map. If you want to track that courier details, just click on this location map icon, and you will be able to see the details, right? So you can see this is the details, and this is the full information. You can search the information from here also, right? This is the, you can see this is the full map, real-time Google map, right? You need to generate the I have integrated the Google map API in this application. So if you get this project, then you need to add the Google map API here inside the system to make this workable, right? Without that Google Map API, you will not be able to plot the map, and you will not be able to perform any type of Google Map operations, right? So you can see this is the tracking information. Let me show you the another. So if you click on this one, then you will be able to see the courier is traveling from Mumbai to Kolkata, and there is only two locations here, right? And you can see the list here, right, with the date, right? So this is the things, right? This is the my account session from where you will be able to log out from the systems, right? Let me show you the courier details, right? Sorry, the API details, right? From which you need to integrate into your devices, right? So let me show you, let me open it. Documents. So one more thing I want to show you, so if you have the, if you are planning to host, means make this application on the, host this application on the cloud, then you can easily create a MySQL database and launch a PHP application, launch the PHP software on that hosting, and after that it will work properly on that cloud environment, right? So this is the right. So I am device and devices, right? So this is the API. So this URL, it will be changed according to your cloud URL or you according to your API URL, right? So so if you host this application, and it must be your public IP, right? If you make a, if you use the same thing on your devices, then it will not work because it's a local host IP. So for sending the data to this application, you need to change this URL. You need to replace this URL from your public IP, from your cloud URL, right? After that, it will work. And you need to send the device ID. You can see this is a device ID, and you need to send this device ID inside the application to make this workable, right? So this is the API URL, right? One more thing I want to show you, from where you need to add the GPS, means a Google Map details. Then what you need to search, Google Map API, right? So once you search on the Google Map API, then get an API key, right? So what you need to do is that you need to follow the information. This is the information. Go on the Google Cloud Platform console, and this is the information, and you will get the API key, what you need to integrate in the functions.php, which is available in the admin folder, and inside the include folder. You need to replace that Google Map API to add the Google Map here inside your project, right? So this is the information you need to integrate that. Okay, so I am at the end of, I am updating the technology stack again. So the first thing, this is the IoT based application, this is the cloud based application, this is the real time GPS tracking application. You can integrate any of the GPS devices with this application. You can and develop your device using the Arduino and the NodeMCU, or the any of the board like Arduino, NodeMCU, and the Raspberry Pi, Banana Pi. You can add any of the GPS devices which is available in the market, which provides the facility to integrate the API, right? You can use your mobile devices to send the informations, and you can send the information to that public URL, and those lat long will be recorded inside the system, and after that you can track the things, right? So these are the, and you can host this application on AWS, on the public server, anywhere inside the system, right? So these all things I have developed inside this project, right? So if you need more information, if you need more functionality in this project, just send me email or text me on WhatsApp, right? For adding more features inside this project, and I will add those pieces. I will make this project more better and better according to your requirements. And for getting the more good project functionalities, don't forget to subscribe our channel for getting the latest project videos on the latest technologies. And thanks for watching the video. Thank you very much.